I really hope this is in frame because I'm not checking anything. But hi everyone, it's me again and the vlog is back. So I apologize first of all because I completely bummed out last month and did not get anything out for February. I did record stuff, but I didn't do anything with it because last month was super busy. And for whatever reason, February is the busiest month. At least that's what it feels like. Maybe because it's the shortest month of the year and there's a lot of stuff that usually happens, or like, I don't know, but it just didn't work out. So this vlog is going to be a recap of everything that happened in February, because otherwise I would have skipped over this, but there are some important parts to talk about and I'm gonna try not to ramble so long. So wish me luck. We'll see how long this is. And then I will throw in some clips from over last month that I recorded as Neepy. And I don't know why I'm talking like this, but I am. So here we go. Let's do this. What time is it? All right. Let's hope we don't spend 40 minutes talking about this. So the first thing that ended up happening last month was I finally got to see my new doctor. Dolly, stop hissing. Cooper, be part of the vlog. Lay down. Thank you. So the first thing that ended up happening was I saw my new doctor, my new gynecologist, and she was very nice. And I'm very happy that she's very nice. She is really young, probably around my age, maybe a little bit older. And I took somebody's advice from my previous video. I wrote everything down on paper, all of my symptoms, my questions, my concerns, my whatever. I brought it in, I gave it to her. She read everything over, she answered everything, and she agreed with me that she felt like one of the medications was causing me a lot of issues and symptoms and side effects. So she wanted me to try it in a cream form instead of a pill form. Now, the only downside with the cream form is that it's not covered on insurance because it's kind of one of those special things. I don't even know why insurances don't cover it. Cooper, your whiskers are in my ears. Oh, you put them back in my ears. So I have been on the cream for about a month, and knock on wood, but it seems to be working. And I say knock on wood because there's still a lot of testing and stuff that needs to be done to actually see how the levels are going inside my body. But as far as my obvious symptoms and issues, okay, bye, Coop. As far as my obvious symptoms and issues that I had going to the doctors in the first place, they're gone. So that makes me feel a lot better. There's no abnormal bleeding or spotting or any kind of issues. There's no pain down there. Everything is kind of okay. So I'm kind of also in this mentality of what's gonna happen next and when is it not going to be okay. But the weird part was when I ordered the cream, I had to call a compounding center and have them mail it to me via, you know, postal mail. And this is what it showed up like. So it came in a USPS box that was literally just this. I'm not going to flip it over because I want to give some discretion to the place. But inside... like this looks ridiculous. Like, come on, this looks like either like a tampon or like a vagina applicator. It looks so funny. But this is the cream that I am to put either on my arms, my stomach, or my thighs. But like this is it. It is nuts. It is absolutely. And I still laugh about this. Like, this is funny to me. Also, may I remind you that this came in a sandwich bag. Like, is this not the most shadiest thing that you've ever seen in your life received in the mail? Like, when you expect getting a medicine in the mail,
Do you expect this? Because I didn't.
So yeah, that was fun. But regarding of what it looks like, it actually works. So I guess, cool. And the other thing was she increased one of my pills because my thyroid levels were just a little bit too low. And I ended up taking two of them and then ended up experiencing a bunch of really crazy fucking side effects, including really bad sweating, like excessively sweating, and just from the sweating produced rashes. Because that's what everybody wants. They want rashes that bleed. So that stopped. So finally, after that whole period, that was great. And it was weird because we didn't know it was the pill. We thought it might have been the cream. So she told me to just go down the one pill and then see if it gets better. And then it got better. So like, it's all over, thank God. So then the next step to test to see if this cream is working is they need to do a saliva test on me. So it's literally this kit that she gave me right in the office that I have to follow. It's a spit test kit. So I have to literally fill up this tube of spit and then I gotta package it up and then send it off. And then I don't know how soon the results come back, but I don't have to do that until April. So I still have time before I have to do that, but I do have the kit. So I've never done a spit test before, but I guess it's pretty accurate as far as, you know, registering all your hormones and like how everything is in your body. And I even have explicit directions, like when I take it, I can't eat anything, I can't drink anything, I have to take it during like a certain day in my cycle. And like at the same time that I have that done, I also have to go and get more blood work done. There's this whole slew of things, but I'm hoping, I'm really, really hoping that the light is at the end of the tunnel and that we can finally realize what's going on and then just move on with life. And she did go over the possibility of endometriosis, which is interesting because many doctors before her have said the same thing. And then they do like one little itty bitty test and then they go, eh, no, you don't have that. So I'm curious what she thinks of it and see how far she goes with it. She told me to go home and research it. I researched it and it seems like there's a lot more testing that needs to be done for endometriosis rather than just like, you know, blood work like everybody else does. They go, eh, you know, it's not that. And I also have to do another ultrasound, but endometriosis, I guess they do biopsies for, which I wasn't aware of, but there's surgery that can be done for it. They don't really recommend hysterectomies because it doesn't really help. So like, it's a possibility I might have that, but since the cream is working, maybe it's something else. Maybe it's just my levels are out of whack. I don't know. But good news from all of this and the new medicine working is that because of the bleeding issues going away and just the overall pain, which was my biggest concern, is I didn't want to go back to the hospital for any kind of ovary or like uterus pain. I finally started going back to the gym and working out again. So, and it seems to be going well aside for the fact that I still have a knee problem. But baby steps, at least we've got this figured out. And I also figured out that if I wear these knee sleeves, these knee brace sleeves thing, that it doesn't hurt as much. So I'm wondering if my knees are just as a result of me being so overweight, which is a good possibility. The only thing my doctor offered for the knees was physical therapy, but if I'm moving anyway, then I'm just gonna wear this and just go to the gym and walk and do whatever I need to do. So, you know, baby steps, little wins, let's do this. Then around the, actually exactly on February 14th, John and I went to New York. We went to Middletown, New York to the Galleria Mall to hang out for the day at Round One. It's one of our favorite mall arcade places. There's no Round Ones really close to us. We don't have like Dave and Buster's or anything nearby. So it was just a really cool day to just get out, hang out for the day, took the day off work and just spent it at a mall. Like we like hanging out at malls. I know that's not really the cool or popular thing to do. And you know, there's a slew of other activities you can do, but we like hanging out at malls because it's like an all-in-one thing. You can eat there, you can shop there, you can play there, you can do a bunch of stuff. And it was also our 9-year anniversary. Yes, right? John and I have been dating for 9 years. It is crazy. And next year marks 10. 10 years! Holy fuck. I feel like that old married couple when we're together, because we've just been together so long but not married. So not like I'm complaining. I'm completely content. But it is very nice to just spend time with your loved ones. And we like doing a lot of stuff together. We like traveling together and like visiting stuff and trying new things. So it was just a very nice time to spend Valentine's Day of all days just hanging out together, playing DDR and all kinds of games at the arcade, trying to win prizes and stuff. But that's just our favorite pastime, so I'm completely cool with that. Not too far before we went to New York, I actually got sick again and had a really super nasty cold. I'm now convinced that what I experienced in December around Christmas time was bronchitis, and this time was just a really nasty cold, not necessarily the flu, but just a really bad cold. And it is concerning because I do have an autoimmune disease, so it was kind of a wake-up call, like, I'm not as healthy as I used to be, and I have to be super careful. Which doesn't really help now that the fact the coronavirus is, like, the biggest threat, so, you know, I have to be careful, unfortunately. And there's not a hell of a lot I can do about it, because I still have to go to work and stuff. But luckily, I was only sick for, like, 5 days, and it was just, like, sinus infection, ear infection, sore throat, just feeling like it was just all head. It wasn't really anything else. It was just all up here, thankfully. But I was able to feel better right before we went to New York, thank God. So I am probably gonna have to look into more preventative measures now that my immune system is shit. Because I don't want to get sick again, because that's twice in the same season. Normally, if I get sick, it's super minor, or it's like one really bad flu and then I'm golden. But the fact that I got sick twice this winter season is concerning. So I have to be careful with that. John also, at the end of February, helped me set up my new green screen that I have now for the channel, which is something I've wanted for a long time. Like, I think I wanted it more back when it was popular, and now that I see that a lot of people are straying away from it, but I would like to rock it for a little while and just see how it is. I think it would be really cool for some upcoming games that I can, you know, have that as like a feature in my videos, so it just kind of gives it a little bit more quality. It is a pain to set up, I will say that. I have one of those pop-up green screen. So it's not just like just a screen that pulls down like those fancy ones. It's this one that just kind of like slaps open like a pop-up tent, and it's so impossible to like fold down. Like, it takes so much effort, and when it's like 2 in the morning and I'm trying to do it, it's not ideal. But I still love it and I'm trying it out, and John also got me some nice lights to use with the screen, so like everything looks really cool. There's just a lot of cords and cables and stuff happening around me, but we're gonna be rocking the green screen for a while. I don't know how much longer I'll do it, because it looks like the green screen is ripping. I guess the material is very cheap, so it's like actually ripping around the edges already, and it's and I got it in December, and I've only used it like maybe like three or four times. So I don't know. We'll see how that goes. Also, that super secret project that I was working on, I was working on for a while, I have been doing kind of secret recordings of a game that I would like to put on the channel. And I started it in January. I posted a teaser saying I've got some really cool things coming up. I can't wait to show you guys. Yeah, February, I didn't touch the game at all, which is bad because the game is like over 20 hours long or something. So I'm not very far in it at all. So that's what I'm actually going to do today after this is done. I want to actually jump back into the game and record. I didn't play much games at all in February. Like, I'm trying to keep a personal goal to myself, kind of like a promise, to not just play games for YouTube or for Twitch, or just basically for you guys, but play games for myself as well. Stuff that I wouldn't record for, you know, any purposes other than just for myself. So I, you know, played a bunch of games in January. I had really fun time with Donut Hole. And then at the end of January, I started Roombo, which is like you're a, you know, a deadly Roomba. And you get to set traps up for burglars and eat people. It's a fun game. But yeah, last month I didn't play anything other than stuff for the channel. So I did Simulacra 2, but I didn't do any personal recordings or anything. I didn't even do like Drawful 2 or Movie Night or anything. Like February was just kind of like whoosh. It was just gone. By the time I realized what was going on, it was over. So now that it's March, being March, I do have... I am busy, obviously. I'm always busy. But I do have some things planned, some things that I would like to do. So I would like to record more of my game. I want to work on finally getting a fucking updated trailer because I don't have a trailer for the channel anymore. I have been so lazy with it. I have to back up stuff on my computer. I want to get back into vlogging again, more than just this. Like, I'm thinking about just doing bits and pieces here and there, maybe like every other week or something, or as needed, as intended. Because obviously there's times I can't really vlog at all. Cooper, what you looking at?
Look at you sitting over there. What you doing, bud? You having to sit? You having to sit? Hmm? Having to sit, buddy? Say hi to everybody. He's like, okay, get it out of my face. I'm done.
So that's pretty much it. Like, a lot happened, but not a lot happened as far as stuff that I had vlogged and recorded. And if anything that I missed, I'm going to show it now. We went to Middletown. We went to round one. That was our main objective, to hang out for the day. We love round one. It's like a giant arcade for, like, everyone of all ages. It's like a Dave and Buster's, but not really. And they have DDR machines. They have, like... groove coaster machines, they have like claw machines, they have all kinds of stuff. It's so much fun. They had, this year, they had a new Tsum Tsum. Is it pronounced Tsum Tsum? Zoom Zoom? Tsum Tsum? Disney game, which is for some reason so addicting. I have no idea why it's addicting, but it's addicting. And it was just fun. So we did that. We walked around. We had cheesesteaks at Charlie's. Their cheesesteaks are very good. We don't have a Charlie's around here, so I always try to do something or go somewhere or visit and just hang out for the day, and we had a blast. And I got to try, like, a bubble drink for the first time, which if you don't live in Pennsylvania, or at least you don't live in, like, the northeast part of Pennsylvania, there are no bubble drinks. Like, these bubble drinks, they're like a milk tea with like some kind of, I think the generic is like a tapioca or like a custard ball or something. There are these little like black bubbles that sit at the bottom of the drink. They look like blueberries, but they're not. And I ordered one of those for the first time because I never had one. And it was amazing. It was so good. So it was just a really cool experience. We literally stayed at the mall for 8 hours and then came home, had pizza, and passed out because we were so freaking tired. But we had such a great day. And yesterday we just lazed around and we were just like super tired, super exhausted, super sore. But overall, a really good day.
That's a ball of baby right there. Hi, ball of baby. You a ball of baby. Yeah. Getting some scritches. You want to say hi to everybody? He's like, no. She's like, Mom, you woke me up. Now I gotta clean myself because you touched me. And I gotta curl back up and go to sleep for like 6 hours. Yeah? I'll leave you be, okay? Give you another head scratch and leave you be. You cool? Hi, Goopy. What's up, buddy? You were having the snooze, too. Not a buddy, bud.
So this is some of the stuff that we have in our fridge. This is the peach. We also have lychee. And then melon we can get here. Watermelon we can't. So we have watermelon. I think that's it. I think that's all the flavors. And that wraps up this part, this video, this vlog. So thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you guys sooner than later. Bye-bye.